Thank you. my way.
Thank you.
not.
I will not hold back.
away with you!
The gate did open again, and delivered the most mouth-watering morsels. Circle of such pleasure I will take in delivering you unto your grave.
Thank you. You underestimate me!
This Scarmaglione, he knew the gate had opened.
And not for the first time. He and his brethren must keep watch over the portal.
As we do ours, but to unflinchingly consume a fellow Voidsent. Like men, perhaps they form factions and fight amongst themselves.
The question is, what will the minions do?
Your mistress is no more, and the one who consumed her we slew in turn. Do you still mean to try us?
I expect some Voidsent are more intelligent than others. Perhaps these ones simply do not understand our words.
Even beasts ought to understand strength.
There is much we do not know about Void Scent. If we are to survive their world, it would be wise to learn their ways. Sage advice, my friend. 'Tis reassuring to have one so experienced with us. I am here, sister. Finally here. And I will find you. I swear it.
see it now. The bottomless darkness. The insatiable hunger. The aura was present when we faced him in Garlemald.
How did it come to be here?
When Xenos died, its connection to the source was severed. It was forced to return to the void.
Xenos. Yes, that was his name. And you are the friend, are you not?
Is that Heidelin's crystal?
But how? The light just now. Of course. And thus I am returned.
What do you mean, returned? Who are you?
I was once bound to the man named Xenos. His avatar, until you killed him.
Avatar, as in the Void-sent servants of Reapers. In the name of his hunt, Xenos took up that traditional Garlean art. And through it, he forged a covenant with a being of the Void to lend him strength.
Covenant? A curse, more like. He stole my power. There was no equity in the arrangement. My very essence was altered, twisted into a tool to serve his desires.
Your previous appearance, this is your true form then?
Perhaps, perhaps not. What does it matter?
Indeed, it doesn't. Regardless of your form, you are a void sent by nature. So answer me this. Are you our enemy too?
In this world, only a fool would attempt to devour a stronger being. And though it was as an avatar, I lost you once, I have no desire to lose again.
Good enough for me.
Now, you will answer me a question. Xenos called you friend. That's what you are? A friend? So, you're not a friend. Then, what is it? What is a friend? This is where I belong. My home. This endless darkness you call the void. There was once light here, and it shone its warmth upon creation. The lands were green and the seas were blue. Life flourished. Before the war, the Contra Memoria.
It must have been a terrible war indeed.
It shattered the balance, causing darkness to engulf the world. All life was transformed into monstrosities, void sent. We are the natural order now.
As light begat sin eaters, darkness begat void sent.
The sun was driven from the sky as fleeting day yielded to endless night. In time, even land and sea lost their distinction. And though the spark of reason had died in us, driven by memory's shadow, we formed factions and carved out domains. This castle, for instance, its erstwhile lord must have abided in such a place once upon a time.
If I may, the darkness in you is too much for any man to harbor. To my eyes, you are indeed a void sent. Yet your knowledge of the past and your demeanor mark you apart from your brethren. You are different, that much is plain. But in what way, I am unsure.
As you say, I am void sent, but only in part. The darkness touched my mother when the war had only just begun, when I was still in the womb. As a child, I looked like any other, but darkness coursed through me, and I ceased to age when I become a woman grown. But that was then, and now, I may as well be one in full. I prey on the weak and serve the strong. I live to survive. Nothing more.
Forgive me. 'Twas not my intent to pry. I realize, too, that I have neglected to ask your name.
As we say mortal, you may call me void sent.
That is liable to cause confusion. If you are not averse, we would address you by your true name.
Then call me what you will. I care not.
How about Zero?
Meaning nothing. A name as fitting as any.
No, not nothing, but rather a beginning. For it remains to be seen what you will become to us.
As I said, I care not. Zero, then. A name is a string of sounds. Its meaning has no bearing on my nature.
Well, Zero. While there is no end to the questions we could ask, it is only fair that we tell you our purpose in coming here. We are searching for a dragon, one who came to your world long ago.
A dragon?
Yes. Ajdaya is her name, and she is my sister. If you have any knowledge of her, I beg you share it with us.
Yeah.
Did you say something?
No.
I thought I heard a voice as well. The keening of void scent, perhaps.